Hey Calera, it's May, which means graduations are happening, the weather is getting beautiful, and summer is upon us. We're gonna be talking to some seniors. They're gonna tell us what is in store for them after they leave Calera High School. We are gonna talk with our police officers about the new drug dog, and the mayor and the city clerk are gonna show us how to navigate the city website and some easy ways to pay our bills. We hope you enjoyed this episode. I know many of you may have seen our new addition to the police force. He's a little hairy, but he's really cute. He is doing some work, right?
Yeah.
And this is, who is this? Tell us.
His name's Kodak.
Okay, so Kodak is the new police dog, and he looks really cool, but he actually has very, very important job, right? Which we'll get to in a little bit about what he does. Chief, can you tell us a little bit about how did Kodak come to be on the Calera Police Department, and how was Officer Allen selected to be the one to be in charge of Kodak?
So we just saw a need with the amount of drug activity that's taken place all across the country. Mm-hmm. Canines are, you know, the best way to try to find those drugs when they're hid. So we decided that a canine would be a big benefit for the department to add that to our staff. We chose Officer Allen because he's a very proactive officer. He does a great job. He has a great attitude. He's well liked amongst the officers, his peers, the community, and he has the motivation and the dedication to do this job. It's a never-ending job. It's a 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week job.
So Kodak goes home with Officer Allen, is that correct? Like, he lives with him?
That is correct. Officer Kodak goes home with Officer Allen. And Officer Allen takes care of him 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. He's always his partner. They remain partners after duty. So it is a big task. It's a big chore, but it's very rewarding for the officer and the department, as well as the community.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, you know, I think that does speak very highly of you that you were selected for this process. And like he said, this is not a 9-to-5 thing. Officer Kodak lives with you, and you guys train together. Can you talk to us a little bit about that training? What has he and you gone through?
Well, when I first got selected, I had to go off to a canine school in Tuscaloosa for 5 weeks.
Wow.
And when we got there, you know, I got Kodak picked me, and we had to just learn his, because his language is in Czech.
Czech?
He got Czech, Dutch, he got a little bit of German command. So I had to learn everything about that, and I had to learn, you know, how to work the dog, you know, how to do the searches correctly, and, you know, how to notice when something's ain't right, and, you know, when he's doing something wrong. So I did 5 weeks there, and it was a long 5 weeks.
I can imagine that was. And I know that he's still kind of in training,
right?
New, still got things to learn, I'm sure. But I know that he does a lot. What all will he be doing within the department?
Well, he's a narcotics and tracking dog. So, you know, he's good at finding narcotics. And also, if somebody runs away from an officer, a kid get lost and wanders off in the woods, he can also find them as well.
What a great addition for Calera.
Within the first 30 minutes of Officer Allen and Officer Kodak being on shift, they were actually doing a tracking in the woods. Within 30 minutes of both of them coming on duty the first day.
That is absolutely amazing. I think Kodak's gonna show off a little bit for us. We're gonna see a little bit about what he can do.
Right.
Sound good? All right, let's do it.
So, Officer Kodak is extremely hyper. All day long, all he wants to do is work. His whole day is about working. And you see there, he's already indicated on it. He's already smelling it. The officer's trying to, he just indicated. So he sat. As he sits, that indicates that he's just located the narcotics. But his whole day, he's a working dog, so these dogs, all they think about is working, which in reality is playing for them. That's all playing. So he just got his toy. His whole reason for doing what he's doing is to get his toy. And so all day long, all he wants to do is play. But that is actually working for us. It's him locating what he needs to locate, and he gets rewarded by getting his toy.
So I've had the privilege this morning of talking with some of these seniors from Calera High School, and I am so pumped to share with you guys what just a little bit of what I have heard from y'all. Y'all are some amazing kids, and I know you're going to do some amazing things. So tell us a little bit about your time here at Calera. What have been some of your favorite moments throughout your last 4 years here?
Throughout my last 4 years, I really do enjoy our pep rallies and stuff where we get to have competitions with our underclassmen.
Oh, pep rallies are the best, right? What about you, Hal?
Somebody set a popcorn bag on fire in the microwave, and we had to evacuate the whole school because the fire alarms went off. That was pretty funny.
When was this?
It was sophomore year.
That's awesome, and that's a story you'll always remember too, right?
What about you, AB?
Mine was hitting a game-winning shot versus Chilton County, and just having all my Calera supporters there cheering my name and all that stuff for my team, that was just great for me.
Everybody told me that AB is pretty amazing at basketball, so that's pretty awesome. What about you, Ryan?
Mine would just be last year, just playing soccer, just most of the memorable times down there.
Yeah, that's awesome. Okay, what about you, Jose?
My most favorite memory is playing soccer for the past 4 years.
So two soccer players right here, right? That's cool. And you told me that your biggest rival is probably Montevallo, right? All right, watch out, Montevallo. Talk to me about, I know that our teachers play such a big role in our lives. Who are some of the teachers that have made the biggest impact on you guys?
Probably my ROTC instructor, Major Garcia.
Okay.
Mr. Drackett, our AP Environmental Science and our biology teacher. He's had some pretty big impact on all of us, really.
That's cool.
Probably my marketing teacher, Mr. Pope. He continues to strive others to do better.
I would say Mr. Ellis, the physics teacher. He taught me many things this year.
Cool. What about you, AB?
Definitely my former math teacher, Ms. Morris, and my current math teacher, Ms. Waldrop.
We got to thank those math teachers because math, whew, right? All right, now I got the inside scoop on where these guys are going, so they're going to share it with you too. And I love it because you all have very different paths that you're going on. Hal, tell us a little bit about what you're doing in the future.
I'm going to college at South Alabama to get a degree in civil engineering, and then I'm going to join the Corps of Engineers in the Army and go to Ranger School and try and go Special Forces.
Love it. And you told me that you kind of grew up in a military family, so you got a little bit of that background, right?
Yep.
Awesome. What about you, Brian?
I'll be attending South Alabama as well for mechanical engineering, and then after that I'm planning to like get into design and all that stuff for.
Okay, you are that's smart, okay? I told you were smart. What about you?
I'm planning on going to Idaho at Brigham Young University and just studying and trying to figure out which I want to major and minor in.
And I asked you, Idaho, like why did you pick Idaho and what did you tell me?
I told her that I wanted to like just get out of the state and to go to a college in which I'll be able to have fun in.
Yeah, and I think it's so cool because you are going to experience a totally different culture than here in the South. And you've been here in the South for most of your life, so that'll be really cool to experience. What about you, AB?
I'll be going to Huntington College in Montgomery to play basketball and to get my degree in accounting.
That will be awesome. We'll be cheering you on. All your Calera fans will be cheering you on, I'm sure. What about you, Jose?
I'm going to go to Jeff State for 2 years and then transfer to Alabama to get a degree in mechanical engineering.
That is wonderful. And we talked about you living at home those first 2 years, which is a very wise decision, saving a little bit of money and getting those core classes done. I love it that you guys all have had this similar experience here at Calera together, but yet you're all choosing very different paths to go on. And I think it just shows that there's no one right way for everyone. And we wish you guys the absolute best of luck and can't wait to hear all the wonderful things you're going to do. But thank you for talking with us today, guys. All right, now, Mayor, I know that I'm a little bit technology challenged, and some of our citizens may be as well, but we've got a really awesome website the city website, there's so much on there. People probably don't even know what all it offers to them, don't you think?
I would think so. And we need to tell the public how to use the website and what's available on the website.
Right. So, for example, city council meetings. Life happens, right? We've got kids. We're crazy busy, right? So we can't always make it to the council meetings. But they can pull up the agendas online. Is that right?
Yes, you can pull up the agenda. You can look at what's going on for announcements, mm-hmm. events, up and coming. So the city website is a very valuable tool for our citizens.
Yeah, just to give us a little bit more of a breakdown of what happened at these meetings if we can't make it. There's also a really cool option on here to pay your utility bills, which I think is great. And if there's a little misstep, you can also pay some other things on there, right? What else?
You can pay traffic citations.
It's okay. It happens.
Right? Oh, yeah.
That's real life. But you can pay that on the website, and you can pay your utility bills. So we are going to bring somebody in. Tell us who we're going to bring in to kind of show us how to navigate these things.
We're going to bring Connie Payton, our city clerk. She is an expert at this website.
All right, Miss Connie Payton, city clerk. I hear you're the expert around here. Is that accurate?
I just try to help the citizens as best as I can.
I think she's the expert around here. So you're going to show us how to pay. No, we're going to look at the agendas first, right?
That's correct.
Okay, walk us through it.
You would pull up our city website at www.cityofclera.org. Once you come to our home page, you would go to the government tab, pull down to City Council, and under City Council there is a section that says Agenda and Minutes. You can click that. When it comes up, you will be able to see here all of our archives for our budgets, our council agenda, council minutes, our financial statements, and all agendas and minutes for our other boards such as Park and Rec, Planning and Zoning, any public notice, our water board agenda, our meetings. And all of these documents are online going back to 2008 when Mayor Graham came in the office.
I love that it's broken down by section so you can look at the things that are personal to you or something that is very specific that you want to focus on. So it's broken down. So that is a great way to check out what's going on in the city council. Let's do it. Can we pull up whatever? What do you think?
Let's
pull something up.
We'll do financial statements.
Okay.
You would just come to the financial state section and you would want to choose either the water board or the city council. And you just click it and it pops up and there's all the information you're needing to review.
That couldn't be easier. I like it.
Thank you.
Okay, so now we want to focus on bill paying. So like the mayor said, we can pay our utility bills online. We can also pay any traffic tickets online. So show us how to get there.
Okay, you would go back to our homepage. When you get back to our homepage, you would scroll down and it says online payments right here in the middle on the right. You would click that. Then here you can choose either your court for a traffic citation or your utility billing, and you would click that. And you have two options here. You can do a quick pay or you can do a login. On the quick pay, you would click here. You would need your account number and your last payment amount. When you're using your account number, remember to enter the dashes in to bring that information up and your last payment amount. If you don't remember your account number or your last payment, give us a call at 668-3500 and we'll give you that information.
Wonderful. That is super easy. Now, you also talked to me about a kiosk that people can pay utility bills. So I think we're going to head out there and check that out now. Okay, so we're outside in front of City Hall. This is like the main entrance, and there is our wonderful bill paying kiosk. Tell us about it. What do we need to do here?
If you're not able to get in the office to pay your bill during our regular hours of 8 to 5 or pay online, we have this option here. You can walk up to the kiosk. You will touch the start screen here. You would need to know your account number, or if you don't remember your account number, you can look up by your street address. You would just put your street address and your last number and it will bring it up. At this kiosk, you are available to use a check or a credit card to make your payment.
Wonderful, that's so easy.
And it will also give you a receipt.
Okay, so it'll give us a receipt and there's plenty of different options. Now, you did tell me something about keeping our phone numbers current.
That is correct. If everyone will make sure their telephone number is correct with us, we do a robocall 2 times a month to remind the citizens if we haven't received their utility payment.
we can all use a reminder from time to time, so that's wonderful. Thanks for making it so easy and for letting us know all about it.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I had a blast filming this, and I hope that you enjoyed watching it. Make sure that you like and share our videos, and we want to give a huge thank you to the city for allowing us to come out and do this. We'll see you next month on Calera Living May.